Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Civil Learning Online. And today in this video I will be discussing about the iteration method. Previously I have made 3 videos about the bisection method, regular falsi method and the Newton-Raphson method. This is my 4th video about the solution of or finding the root of nonlinear equations. And student, if you want to know what are linear and nonlinear equation, you should check out my video based upon the bisection method. In that video I have clearly mentioned what are linear and nonlinear equation and the different methods of finding the roots of the linear and nonlinear equation. Here there are 4 methods for finding the root of nonlinear equation, out of which iteration method is the only method which gives us the real root. And all the other 3 methods that are Newton-Raphson method, bisection method and the regular falsi method gives the approximate root, which is not exact the real root. And without wasting time, let's begin the solution. And before beginning the video, I would like to give you the brief introduction about the things which we are going to do in this video. First of all, as you can see, according to the concept of the iteration method, here it says that x is equal to zeta is the root of the equation fx is equal to 0 and I be the interval containing the point zeta. Means we here in this while solving this numerical, we will find the integer like interval in which and the our root or the value of x will lie between that two values. Suppose we have found the root as 1 and 2, then our value like 1.56 or something which will be the solution of x will lie between these two interval, which is denoted by I. And for that, let phi x and phi dash x be the continuous function in interval I, where phi x is defined by the equation x is equal to phi x. If any equation which we are asked to find by solve by using the iteration method, we will write it in the form of x is equal to phi x, and then we will find the root of derivative of phi x, which is denoted by phi dash x. And then the first condition for the application of the iteration method is that the modulus of phi dash x should be less than 1. And this theory will be more clear in this numerical. And so let's see how the numerical is solved. Now here we are given the equation, which is x cube plus x square minus 100 is equal to 0. Now the very first step what we need to do is we have to write this equation in the form of x is equal to phi x. So let's write it. Then how we can write it, let us suppose this will be x cube is equal to 100 minus x square, or x is equal to 100 minus x square to the power 1/3. Now you can see that this is in the form of x is equal to phi x, which the theory says, means we have got this. Now the second thing what we need to do is we have to find phi dash x, means derivative of phi x, means we have to find its derivative. So phi dash is equal to 100 minus x square to the power 1/3. Now find its derivative. So its derivative is going to be phi dash x is equal to 100 minus x square to the power 1/3. So its derivative is going to be n times x to the power 1/3 minus 1. So this is going to be 1/3 times 100 minus x to the power minus x square to the power 2/3 into this derivative of minus x square will be minus 2x. So we have got the value of phi dash x. Now here I have got the value of phi dash x. Now what I need to do is I have to find the integer between which our value of x will lie. From here I can write that x minus 100 minus x square to the power 1 by 3 is equal to 0. Now what I will do is I have to put the value of x one by one from 1 or 1, 2, 3, 4 like this, and then I will find a positive and negative value, and that will be our integer between which our root will lie. As you can see, it can be written as fx is equal to x minus 100 minus x square to the power 1 by 3. So f1 is going to be 1 minus 100 minus 1 to the power 1 by 3, which will be solved by using calculator. So this is going to be 1 minus 100 minus 1 to the power 1 by 3, which is going to be minus 3.626. Similarly, f2 is going to be 2 minus 100 minus 4 to the power 1 by 3. So this is going to be minus 2.57. similarly, f3 will be equal to minus 0.379, and f4 is going to be 0.78, sorry, f4 is going to be minus 0.379, and f3 will be minus 1.497, f4 will be minus 0.379, and f5 will be 0.78. means here I have got positive and negative value, which says that our root will lies between 4 and 5. Means I have got the integer I according to the theory of iteration method. Now after doing this, after finding the integer I, what we need to do is we have to check whether the iteration method is applicable or not. And as you can see, as per the theorem, it says that the iteration method is applicable only if phi dash modulus of phi dash x is less than 1. Means I need to find the modulus of phi dash x. So modulus of phi dash x will be equal to modulus of phi dash x value is here this is phi dash x, so this will be written as minus 2, sorry, this modulus will be become positive 2 by 3 100 minus x square to the power 2 by 3. As we know that our root will lie between 4 and 5, so phi dash 4 is equal to 2 into 4 by 3 times 100 minus 16 to the power 2 by 3 modulus. So this is going to be 8 by 3 times 100 minus 16 to the power 2 by 3, and we have got the answer, which is 0.139, which is less than 1. It says that iteration method can be applicable in this equation. So now let x naught is equal to 4. So x1 is going to be 5 x naught, and we have got the value of phi x, and phi x is equal to 100 minus, here x is equal to phi x is equal to 100 minus x square to the power 1 by 3. So here this is going to be 100 minus x naught square to the power 1 by 3, and we have got the value of x naught, which is 4. So 100 minus 16, this is 4 square, 16 to the power 1 by 3, which is going to be 100 minus 16 to the power 1 by 3, and this is going to be 4.379. similarly, x2, this is going to be 5 x1, which is going to be 100 minus x1 square to the power 1 by 3, and here this is going to be 100 minus x1 means 4.3795 square to the power 1 by 3. On solving this, you will get 100 minus 4.3795 square to the power 1 by 3, which will be equal to 4.323. Similarly, we have to proceed for x3, x4 until we get the 2 to 3 digit after decimal same, and that will be our answer. Similarly, x4 is equal to 5x3. So put the value of x3 in that equation, you will get 4.3308, and this is our x4. Find x5. X5 will be equal to 5x5. So put the value of x4, here it will be x4. So put the value of x4 in that equation which I have shown in the x2 and x1 and x3 also. So you will get 4.3310. And as you can see, after decimal we are having two digits similar, since we can say that the root of equation x cube plus x square minus 100 is equal to 0 is 4.33, which is correct up to 2 decimal place here. And this was the final answer of this question. And students, let me make you clear that why I arrange this equation to find the phi dash x should be less than 1. Why I have done that here, that I have done while solving this numerical, I am going to make you clear by using this equation. See here, I am going to write this equation in the form of x is equal to 5x, and see, this equation can be written in three ways, and out of which only one equation will be valid for phi dash x is less than 1. And I will show you that. See, I can write it as x is equal to 1 minus x cube, or x is equal to 1 plus x to the power 1 by 3, or x times x square plus 1 is equal to 1, or x is equal to 1 by x square plus 1. This is our equation 1, this is our equation 2, this is our equation 3. Now, on taking the derivative of first equation, phi dash x will be equal to minus 3 x square. Derivative of second equation, phi dash x will be equal to 1 by 3 times 1 by 1 plus x to the power 2 by 3. Similarly, derivative of third equation, phi dash x is going to be minus 1 by x square plus 1 to the power 2 into 2x. Now, and here, as you can see, that fx is equal to this, so f1 will be 1 and f0 will be minus 1. So we all know that our solution of the root of the equation will lies between 1 and 0. As you can see, if I will find the modulus of this equation phi dash x, modulus of phi dash x, which will be equal to 3, which is greater than 1. So the, as you can see, equation is the same, but here the according to this equation, which is our first equation, the iteration method is not applicable here, as this is phi dash x is greater than 1. Similarly, here if I put 1 here, then this is going to be 1 by which will here phi dash x is going to be less than 1. But when we put 1 here. This will in 5x, when we put 1 in 5x, this will be equal to 0, and again we put 0 in 5x, this will be equal to 1. So this form is also not valid. This is also not valid, and this is not also this is also not valid for iteration, for the application of iteration method. Only this method will be applicable, and this mode, and also the modulus of phi dash x is going to be less than 1. So we have to find, we have to rearrange the given equation in the different forms as much as we can to find the, so that the modulus of phi dash x will be less than 1, and then we will proceed the solution. I hope this video was helpful to all of you guys, and if this video seems to be helpful to all of you guys, then do like and share. And if you want to see more videos related to civil engineering, then do subscribe my channel. Thank you. Have a nice day.